Have you ever wondered how to make color pop in part of a photo while the rest of it's in black and white? This is called the color isolation effect, and it's a game changer for creating eye-catching designs. I'm going to show you a few easy ways that you can create this effect on your photos and videos. It's a lot easier than you think, and yes, you can do it all in Canva. My name is Kat. This is Canva Catterday. Let's get to it. This is the effect that I am referring to, where you have the background of the image is in black and white, and the foreground or the subject is in color. There are a couple different ways that you can achieve this effect. So let's dive into those. We'll use this original image. It's the same image that I just showed you. And I'm going to show you a couple of different ways to get that effect. You can use a background remover, you can use magic grab, or you can adjust the color filters right on the photo. Let's do that one first. I'm going to click on the photo, and first I want to duplicate this page so I can show you a couple different methods with the same image. Okay, so here we have our photo. Go up here to edit. And you'll want to click where it says adjust. This is going to take us to the filters of this specific photo. Right here, you have an option that says select area. And if you click on this, you have the whole image, the foreground, or the background. We want to change the background. So let's click on background. So we have the background selected. It says right there, background selected. Next, you want to scroll down to where you see saturation. That's what controls how vibrant the colors show up in your image or how saturated they are. All you have to do is take this little handle and drag it all the way to the left. So it's at negative 100, just like that. And you can see how it took that background and it just took all the color out of the background, just like that. So that's method number one, by using the adjustment filters. You want to make sure if you're going to use this, that on the area selected, you are only choosing the background image. I mean, you could do it to the foreground as well, but you want to make sure that it doesn't say whole image. Otherwise, it's going to change the entire photo. So that's the first way to do this. The second way to do this is by using background remover. So the first thing we want to do is take this photo and I want to duplicate it. And I'm going to place this over to the side a little bit because I don't really need it right this minute. I'm going to take this background image and I want to adjust this background image so that there is no color at all, zero color. So once again, we're going to go to edit. I can click on the adjust tab to desaturate this image. I could also go to these filters if I want. I can click see all. There are some color filters down here under the mono tab. You could change it to perhaps one of these. So let's try this one. There we go. We just changed it to that slate, that black and white. So you can see that this is now black and white. Then you're going to take your top image, put it directly on top again. And for the top image, you just want to remove the background. So we're going to click background remover. And there you go. You've got the top image, which is just the woman with her color. And the background image is now that black and white look. So we've got this first one where we simply change the color filter or adjust the color saturation. And then we have this version where we used background remover to add a duplicate and then remove the background of the image underneath. The third way to do this is by using magic grab. And this to me is the easiest way to do it because then you can make little adjustments if you need to. So click on the photo, click on edit, go over here to magic grab. You have the option to either brush or click. I'm going to choose brush because it's a little, I'm sorry, I'm going to choose click because it's a little more precise. So you'll notice that as I'm hovering my mouse, different areas of the image are changing color and kind of turning purple. That lets me know what part it's going to grab out of the image. So I'm going to click right here on the hat. And right now, only the hat will get grabbed. But I want everything else that's part of her to be grabbed as well. So all you'll do is simply hover over the next part of the image and click it again. When you do that, it turns purple. And you'll just keep on clicking these areas until you get everything that you want to be pulled out of that photo that looks like it's got all this purple highlight to it. So I'm going to click right there on her bathing suit, this little part right here. We've got this little part right here. And then we've got one little section right here. and one right there. There we go. So now I have all of this part of the subject has now been grabbed. It's all in purple. I just go right over here to grab. And then Canva is going to pull that out of the image for me. And you'll see it in just a minute. It's been completely removed from the image. And then we can go on and make the rest of the adjustments. So here, you'll see right here, if I move it, see, she's been pulled right out of that image for me. Now I can go to my background and I can once again change the background by using either the filters option or the adjust option. So let me go to, I'll do filters this time again. And I'll go back down to slate. And there you go. You now have the background is in black and white and the subject is in full color. Let's go do a couple other images. We'll grab this one right here, this fun little bird. Again, I'm going to go to edit. This time I think I want the bird and the post that the bird is on to be pulled out as well. So I'm gonna do magic grab and I'm gonna click the bird and I'm gonna click the post and this little tiny part of the bird's foot. I hope it takes that. There we go, great. So there's that part of the bird right there. I'll once again click grab. It's gonna pull the bird off that image for me, and then I can take that background and either desaturate the background or just change it with a filter. So I'll click it, click edit. Let's go to, let's desaturate it this time. Let's go down here. Because I pulled the bird out of the background, right now where it says whole image, I could technically adjust the whole image because that bird has been pulled off. But what I would normally do is choose the background only that way, just in case part of the magic grab didn't get everything. It is only changing the background part of the image. So I recommend adjusting it so that it is that part of the image. And then you'll go down to where it says saturation and desaturate it once again. And once you've done that, now you have both the bird and the post are in color and the background is in black and white. Let's go do one more. I've got this one right here. I think I'll use magic grab for this one. Let's click on our subject. Let's see if it pulls the whole thing. It does. It pulls her all in one shot this time. That makes it kind of easy. And I'll click grab. And then we'll take the background and we'll make the background black and white. Click on the background, edit, and I'll do filters this time again. And we'll do slate, and there you go. You've got the back and black and white background and then the subject in color. What about video? Yes, you can do this with video as well. The process is a little bit different, so let me show you that. I'm gonna grab this video right here. Since this is a video, we can't really use magic grab, at least not yet. Maybe in the future, we'll be able to do that with magic grab. Right now, it only works on photos. So for video, it's a slightly different method. We're going to take this video and we're going to duplicate it, just like that. The top video, I'm going to use background remover. You can use this on videos. So I'm going to click background remover, and it's going to take the background away only from the top video. The background video, I want to make those color adjustments. So you'll click edit. And for now, I'm going to click filters. I can use adjust. Let me go up here to adjust. I can desaturate it if I want to, like that. So you can use the desaturation if you want to. But I'm going to go down here to filters because the video filters are a little different than photo filters. You'll notice on video, you have one down here called grayscale. And that one to me is a little bit closer to what it should look like for a true black and white. So I'm going to choose the grayscale one right there. And then all you have to do is take your top video and line it up with the background video. I'm gonna put it like that. And then we'll be able to play this video. Now, one slight thing you have to be careful of with the videos, because we have two, if for any reason you're playing with the videos here and you're adjusting them or whatever, and you happen to slightly play a video and you notice that the video playhead is not at the very beginning, you'll want to make sure that this is at the very beginning of the video for both the foreground video and the background video, because if it's not, it won't line up properly when you go to play this at the very end. So just take the little playhead. You can see as I'm dragging it, it's changing my time. Make sure it's all the way to the left so it says 0, 0. And then the foreground video, the same thing. Make sure you drag it all the way to the left so that it's 0, 0. And then place it directly on top like that. And when I go to play this, it's going to play everything exactly in sync like it's supposed to. I'm going to take this page and just bring it to the front, and then I'll just hit the playhead. It's going to be a little bit faster this way. Hit play. And there it lines up perfectly because I made sure that the playhead on both the foreground video and the background video were lined up properly with zero. So that is how you create color isolation effects with both photos and videos. It's really a lot of fun, and it's got a lot of interest to your content. If this was helpful, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you can see more videos like this in the future. That's all for this week. I'll see you next time.